But you asked for it and I delivered. Let's go through my best Android browser recommendations. And since I'm about to fulfill a popular request, drop me a like and a subscribe. It's only fair, right? That's the only payment I need. So there are basically two main choices here, a Chromium-based browser and a non-Chromium-based browser. If your whole reason to get a new Android browser is to get away from the Chrome browser, don't be afraid of Chromium. It's just an open source foundation for other browser projects to build upon. All the Google data tracking mumbo jumbo comes embedded into Chrome, not Chromium itself. My top Chromium-based browser pick is the Brave browser, though. They stripped out all interactions with Google servers and added privacy reinforcements called Brave Shields. It's basically a bundle name for a bunch of tools and privacy rules that protect your privacy and security as you browse. But the best part, to me at least, is the integrated ad blocker. It works especially well on Android and even gets rid of video ads without any issues. Hello, cat. Cat. She always meows like I'm murdering her when I pick her up. She likes it, really. Say hello. Kittle. That said, you can participate in the Brave reward system, which gives you a teeny, teeny, tiny Brave crypto payment for watching curated ads. I mean, it's kind of iffy, but hey, it's optional, so I'm not too mad about it. Now, I'm not a huge fan of how busy this browser looks from the get-go. The images, stats, sites, and the Brave rewards icon too. It's a lot. But I was able to turn all of this off in the display settings and even replace the bottom toolbar with a more casual browser look. I also recommended changing the default search engine from Brave to whatever you prefer. I just found that it's not the most accurate. As for performance, Brave is pretty light on the phone. It loads stuff really fast too and can sync across multiple devices. You just need to set that up. So overall, it's a good browser, especially for those who are looking for the ultimate browser for privacy and security. Another Android browser I really like is Vivaldi. It has a very nice UI, but it takes customization to a whole other level. And I'm not talking about changing the theme or a few UI elements. I mean, take a look at the settings. There are so many things here that it can get overwhelming. However, if you start from the basics and then gradually explore Vivaldi, you can basically build the browser of your dreams, since you can even select the specific features that you want to use. One more cool Vivaldi thing is the tabs. It kind of looks like a PC browser thing, but I really like seeing all the things I have open at a glance rather than forgetting about them in a separate tab window. Plus, Vivaldi can handle a lot of tabs without significant slowdowns. It's really surprising how heavy one cat can get. As for privacy, it's not the main focus of the browser, but it still does very well in this area. The browser encrypts your browsing history, so it doesn't matter if you choose to just store data on your device or to sync it. And of course, Vivaldi has an ad blocker, which, from what I've tested, that works pretty good for video ads too. So overall, get this browser if you want to customize your experience to the maximum. But if you're looking for a minimalistic web browser for Android, then check out Cromite. You won't find it in the App Store, but Cromite is open source, so you can download it straight from GitHub. You're hanging around for a really long time in this one, aren't you?
Yes, hello, I am the cat, the new host.
The browser looks like a stripped down version of Google Chrome, so there is no learning curve. Despite the visual similarity, Chromite is built to not track your browsing habits. It's de-Googled, including getting rid of privacy unfriendly features like page preloading or smart search. It also has an actually private incognito mode too. There's an integrated ad blocker as well, and while it does work on regular ads for me, it didn't stop video ads, which is a little bit disappointing. But hey, the development of it is kind of niche, so bugs are basically unavoidable. If you don't mind occasionally dealing with that, then Chromite is a great minimal UI browser to try. Now, if Chromium still gives you the ick, well, you've still got options. A pretty popular choice is Firefox. You kind of look like the Firefox logo, don't you? A little bit. And while it has its faults and features I don't like, such as stuffing the main page with articles, my main gripe is that they don't have their own ad blocker. But they got extensions, people. Over 2,000 of them. So you compare Firefox with uBlock Origin, or whatever else you want. That said, if you want more control over your browser, I suggest looking into Firefox Fox. For example, Waterfox is a lighter version with added privacy features with the main focus on speed and efficiency. You can also tweak and change a lot of things and add extensions to it as well. But it does have an occasional bug, or a few. Another popular Firefox fork is Fennec, which you can find on F-Droid. It adds uBlock Origin to the browser, but it is very bare bones with proprietary Mozilla bits removed. You wanna get down, mate?
Yeah, you too, do.
It's a bit more privacy friendly this way, but I'd still say that if you want maximum privacy, Brave is a better choice. So there you have it. The best Android browser options, at least in my opinion. Let me know what browser you're using or plan to get, even if it's not on my list. I'll meet you in the comments. Thanks for watching this top browser for Android video, and I hope to see you in the next one.